Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Hope that all of you remember what was taught to you in the previous two classes. In today's class, you all will learn something new. But before that, let us see if you can correctly answer some questions. Do you know using the hyperlink how many files can you link to your page? Using the hyperlink option, we can link many files to our current page. On your page, in place of the hyperlink, can you give your own name? Yes, you can use your name in place of the hyperlink. Can you tell if in the formatting toolbar, you do not see some option, then how you can show that option? For doing this, you need to click on the drop-down button which appears on the right side of the formatting toolbar. And then, using the customized toolbar or the visible button, you can show the options that have been hidden earlier. Can you tell if by using the export as PDF option, you can convert more than one page to PDF format? Yes, you can change more than one page to the PDF format. Let us now begin today's class. Switch on your computer and open the writer file. Let us see what we will be learning in today's class. You all will learn about the remaining options of the standard toolbar and also about the options of the file menu that were not taught to you during the basic module, like send, properties, templates, preview in web browser, and printer setting. Can you tell where is the table option in the standard toolbar? In the picture being shown to you, the table option of the standard toolbar is highlighted in red color, as you can see on the screen. Now, all of you use the standard toolbar to make a table. Have you all drawn the table? If you face a problem, then watch the video and, as is being shown in the video, make the table in the same way. With the help of this video, let us now see how we can create a table on our writer sheet. So, to create a table, click on the table option. A box opens. And now you can select the number of columns and the number of rows that you want to keep in your table. So you can keep the number of columns as 4. And if you like, you can keep the number of rows also as 4, both being equal. You can click on OK and a table gets inserted on your writer page. Next, on the top row, you can type the title of the columns. For instance, in the video, we are typing name. In the next column, we are typing class. And in the next column, we are going to type the subject name. So, we are typing a subject name or any data that you want to type. In the video, we have typed English as the subject name. And in the next cell, in the first row, we have typed another subject name, Hindi. Then, below the name, in the first column, we are going to type the names of the students. As is being shown in the video, we are typing Rohan, Pankaj, and Rajan. Now, we also key in the class details. As is being shown in the video, we are typing 10th as the class. for all three students. Now we can type in the marks for the students for English first. So we have typed the marks for all the three students for English. And next we are going to type the Hindi marks in the last column as is shown to you. So this is how we can create a table on our write-up page. The next option is for find and replace. Can you tell what happens with the find and replace option? With the use of the find option, you can find or search for any word in your paragraph or your page, and using the replace option, you can replace this word by a word of your choice. Watch the video and learn more about using the find and replace option. Let us now watch this video and learn how we can use the find and replace option of the standard toolbar on our writer page. Take your cursor to the find option, click there, a box opens and you can type the word or the text that you are looking for or that you want to find in the search for box. As is being shown in the video, we are typing the name Rohan. After you have typed, you can just click on the find button. A small box opens. Click on yes. It shows that the word has been found and it gets highlighted on your writer page, as is being shown in the video. Now if you want to replace it with a different name or a different text, come to the replace with place and type a word there or a name there. For instance, in this video we have typed Sameer, and then click on the replace button. As soon as you click on the replace button, you will see the small box opening. Do you want to continue? Say OK. And you can see that Rohan has been replaced by the word Sameer or by the name Sameer. And you can close this box. Again, if you want to use find and replace, go back to the find option in the standard toolbar. Click there and this box opens. You can type what you are looking for or what you want to find in the search for box. Note that this time we have ticked on the match case option. This means that the case of the word that you have typed should be exactly the same that you are looking for. So if you have typed Sameer in all small letters and you click on find, it will not find the word and it will say, do you want to continue? You can just click OK on these two small windows. It says that the search key was not found because the case was not matching. The Sameer had capital S, but we had not said Sameer. Now when we remove the match case option and do find again, you can see that the word Sameer in our writer page gets highlighted and has been found. Once again, if we want to use the find option, find and replace, we click on the find option. The box opens. This time, let us tick on the match case option and type another word. Search for, and we are typing, as is being shown in the video, we are typing a name here, Pankaj. Since again, the case, match case was ticked in the option. It did not find it because P capital was not there. So this is how the match case option will make a difference. Let's try with P capital and Pankaj. And then if you say find, click on yes here, and you can see that the word Pankaj has been highlighted. In the next case, we have ticked on match case and whole word only. So when we type Raj and search for Raj, it cannot find part of the word, because we have asked it to look for whole words, complete words. So click on yes, click on OK in the small window, and it says that the word could not be found. Now if we remove the match whole word only option or untick it, and then we find again, you will see that from Rajan RAJ is found. This is how you will use the find and replace option. The next option is of the navigator. Can you tell why do we use the navigator option? With the navigator option, you can get to know which files are active at any time. For example, if you insert a table in your page, then the navigator tells you the number of such tables. If you have inserted a picture, then the navigator will tell you the number of the pictures. And by clicking on these, you can directly use the same. Let us watch the video and learn what happens with the use of the navigator. Let us now watch this video and learn what happens with the navigator option. We can use the navigator option directly from the standard toolbar. So when you click on the navigator option, a box opens and you can move this box or drag it to wherever you want. It shows various options. So the navigator can provide you information about tables, about graphics, and about various other things. You can scroll up or down using the scroll bar here, and you can get information about the graphics, about tables, about bookmarks, about hyperlinks, if there are any hyperlinks inserted here. This is how you will use the navigator box. Now we can try and insert something else in our writer page and see how we can use the navigator. So we use the insert option and click on the picture option. Click on from file, and from the box that opens, which is the address box, you can go to the pictures library and click on one of the pictures which gets inserted on your writer page. As you can see in the video, now if we go to the navigator option, you will notice that it will also give you the information related to the pictures. So again, you can scroll up and down and get the information about the tables, about any graphics. Like we have just inserted a picture, or you can get information about hyperlinks. Let us now see for the hyperlink how we can get the information using navigator. So you can scroll up or down on your writer page, keep your cursor here, go to insert again, go to hyperlink option, choose the document option from the box which opens, and select one of the files that you want to provide a link using hyperlink. Click on apply and click on close So you can see the hyperlink gets applied on your writer page. Click on the navigator option. And now you will notice that besides information on the table and the graphics, when you scroll up and down and go to the hyperlink option, select that. Watch in the video. In graphics, it is showing graphic 1 because we have one picture there. So when you select the hyperlink, you can see the file name for which the hyperlink has been provided. So this is how you will use the navigator option on your writer page. The next option is for the gallery. As all of you know, using the gallery, you can insert any picture or object in your file. Now, all of you show how you will insert any picture in your file. In case you face a problem, watch the video and learn from it. Let us now watch this video and learn how we can use the gallery option to insert different objects or images from the gallery by using the standard toolbar. So for this, on our writer page, we take our cursor to the gallery option and click there in the standard toolbar as is being shown in the video. And you can see that many options are available on the left side of the gallery option. It shows various objects, rulers, sounds, symbols, or objects you are looking for. The gallery option provides you a variety of images for those. For instance, if you look at transport, there are many options available. You can select the one which you like. For instance, we have selected on clicked on motorcycle. And to insert this, you click, use the right click, click on insert option, and then click on the copy option. And this image of the motorcycle gets inserted at the place where your cursor was on your writer page. You can drag this image using your mouse or touchpad buttons to a different position where you want to take this image. You can watch in the video. This image has been moved from the table into the picture, and it has also been dragged to a different position in the picture. You can also use the buttons of your mouse and touchpad to resize this image. You can make it larger or smaller, or you can make one end of the image move also. So this is how you will use the gallery option. Next comes the option for non-printing characters. Can you tell what happens with the non-printing characters option? Non-printing characters are those characters which you cannot delete. You can only remove them by re-clicking them. Let us watch this video to understand how non-printing characters are used. This video shows you how the non-printing character option in the standard toolbar is used. Click on the non-printing character option and you will see that on your writer page, the non-printing characters are shown wherever they are existing. If you press enter after keeping the cursor at a position, additional non-printing characters will get inserted in that place. So as in when you keep pressing the enter key, additional non-printing characters keep getting inserted. As is being shown in the video, if you want to remove the non-printing characters, you will again take your cursor to the non-printing character option of the standard toolbar, click on that, and the non-printing character will disappear from your writer page. If you want to bring it back, you will go back to the non-printing character option, click there, and you can see the non-printing characters on your writer page. So this is how you will use the non-printing character option on your writer page. The next option is for zoom. Using the zoom option, show how you will zoom in and zoom out to change the size of your page. If you have any doubts, then watch the video. Let us now see how we can use the zoom option of the standard toolbar for our writer page. When we click on the zoom option, a box opens and you can choose the various variables. If you choose optimal and click on OK, it will show the zoom size which fits into the screen or the picture that we are looking at. You can use various options of the zoom window. Once you click there again on the zoom option, now you can use the fit, width and height and click on OK. So it will fit the picture or the writer page into the available height and width. As you can see, the whole page appears on your screen. Once again, if you use the zoom option and look at the other options here, you can use fit width or you can use variable. When you click on variable, you can change the zoom up or down, zoom in or zoom out, by clicking on the up arrow or the down arrow according to your requirement. So once you have written the percentage of zoom, for instance here 171%, then we click on OK and you can see the zoomed up picture. You can scroll up or down or even sideways to see any part of your writer page. As you know, the normal size of the page is 100%. So you can bring back your page to normal by clicking on 100% also. And you can just click on 100% and then click on OK. And you will find your page returning back to the normal size. So this is how you will use zoom options. Another option available in the zoom window is for view layout. So if you choose single page layout, you will see that the whole page is shown and you can scroll up and down to see your page as a single page. So this is how you will use the zoom in and zoom out option on your writer page directly from the standard toolbar. Let us now learn about the send option of the file menu. Can you tell why we use the send option? Using the send option, you can send your text document with all that you may have typed in it to any other user. In order to be able to send documents, you should have an account on Outlook. Without having this account, you cannot send any documents to other users. Let us learn by watching the video how documents are sent using the send option. In this video, we are going to see how the send option is used. In order to use the send option, we will click on the file option, which is on the top of our page, of the writer page, and then click on the send option. As soon as you click on the send option, various options are available. So let's first look at send document as email option, the first option. We click there. Now to use send, you should have an Outlook account. So as soon as you click here, your Outlook account page will open, giving you the option to send this as an email. So once your Outlook account page opens, you can see there is a column where it says to. In the to column or option, you have to type the email ID or the email address of the user to whom you want to send this document. So we are typing the ID, email ID, connect@computershiksha.org. As is being shown in the video, you have to type the address of the user to whom you are wanting to send this document. Then you need to bring your cursor to the send button and you click on that and your file will get sent. Right now, since we don't want to actually send it, we can just close this Outlook page by clicking on the top right cross sign. Let's see the other options of send. When you click on close, it asks you whether you want to save. You can say no and then come back and click on file option. Click on the send option. Let's look at email the open document text. Email as open document text. Click there. Once again, the Outlook page will open. Remember, to use the send option, you must have an Outlook account. Again, you need to type the email ID of the user to whom you are wanting to send this document. Once again, we are typing connect@computershiksha.org. Note that if you want, you can type some subject matter also in the subject line. The subject indicates what this email is about. Click on send and the document will be sent. Right now we just close it. Since we don't want to save it, we say OK. Click on this OK button again for OpenOffice. Let's look at another option. Click on file. Click on the send option and this time we are going to click on email as Microsoft Word. So now we want to send our document as Microsoft Word in that format. Once we click here, again our Outlook account page will open and as we had done earlier, in the previous option we had seen, we will type the email ID again in the to box. And if you want, you can type the subject. You can even write a small message in the message area if you want. And then once you click on the send option or the send button, this document will be sent as Microsoft Word format. However, since we don't want to use the send button right now, we will just click on the close option of the Outlook page. Click on, we don't want to save, so we will just say no to the save option, which is being shown to us. Click on OK when the Outlook message comes. Let's look at the other options in the send option. So click on file, click on send, and now we can look for email as PDF. Once you click there, the PDF options open. You don't have to do anything. Just click on OK and your document gets converted to PDF. And the Outlook account opens again, that page opens. Again, you will type the email ID of the user to whom you want to send this document. This time, we are sending it as PDF. Close it. Click on, we don't want to save. Once again, let's look at send options. And let's look at create HTML document. So this time if you choose the create HTML document, your document will be converted to HTML format. And once again, the Outlook account will open. And as has been shown in the videos earlier, you will use that to send your document. Let us now learn about the properties option of the file menu. Do you know what happens with the properties menu option? Using the properties option, you can get information about the writer file, like when you had saved the file, etc. You can know the details of the text document, like how many pages are there, how many words are there, how many paragraphs are there, what is the size of the file, etc. Since there are many options of the properties option, like general, description, security, statistics, etc., let us now learn about using these options by watching the video. Let us now watch this video and learn about the use of the property option. There are many options within properties. So we first click on the file menu, click on properties, a box opens. By default, it opens on the general panel. You can see that since this file has not been saved earlier, it is still called untitled. The next information available in this window or box is the type of the document. So this is a text document. It shows the type of the text document. And here, since this has not been saved already, various other options are not highlighted. So we close this, go to the file menu, and first save this document. We can give it a name, like CSS, and save it. Now, when you click on the file menu and go to the properties option, you have saved this file now as CSS, and you will be able to see many options of the properties menu. So here, now you can see the file name. It is an open document text. The location is shown. The size of the document is being shown. And when this has been created or when some changes have been made, modified, is also being shown here. This is how you will get information from the properties general box. The next is the description box. Here you can see the title of the document, and you can define the subject, the keywords. You can also write in some comments in the space provided. For instance, here we are writing Writer Advanced Class. So you can type in some comments that you like. Writer Advanced Class 3 is what we are writing. Then we look, we don't have to see the customs properties, so we will skip that and go to the internet option. Here you can click on or select the redirect from this document, and you can select a document that you want to be linked to. So the box opens, and from here, from the desktop, since you want to link to a desktop file, you will select your file. As is being shown in the video, and click on open. After selecting, click on open. You will see that a link to that file is created in the internet box of the properties option. Then you can click OK. The next option is for security. So if you want to give, say, a password for your file, you can do that with the security feature. Go to file, go to properties, and now click on security option. Here there are two options: open file read only or record changes. So if you click on or if you select the record changes, any changes that are made to the document, you can give by selecting protect. You can give a password, confirm the password, and then click on OK. So now click on OK here also. Now if you make any changes on this document, you can see the changes that you are making, because this document is a protected document. So it will be showing the changes that you are making. Within security, you can also opt to not have a password. So we go to file, we go to properties, come to securities, and now we have clicked on open file read only, and we have unprotected this document by clicking on unprotect, typing in the password, and clicking OK. And you can say yes, you want to make the changes to in this window. So this way, you can now open this file as read only. Next option is of statistics. This uses the properties option to show you the various statistics of this document. For instance, how many number of pages, how many tables are there, what is the number of graphics in it, what are the number of paragraphs, even the number of words and the number of characters can be shown here. So this way you can use properties option to know about your file and use the options of properties. You will now know about the printer settings. Can you tell what happens with printer settings? Using the printer settings, you can connect your computer or laptop to any printer. If you have more than one printer and you wish to connect your computer to one of them, then you can use printer settings to do this. Let us now learn about using these options by watching the video. Watch this video to learn about the printer setting options. There are many options within the printer setting. Take your pointer to the file menu, click there, and then click on the printer settings, which is down here. Click on that. A box opens which shows you the printer setup. It shows you the names of the printers which are available, their status, the type of the printer, the location, if you click on properties, you can get to know more about the various printers which are available. From the drop-down box, you can select. If there are more than one printer, you can select the printer that you are wanting to use. Click on Properties to see the various properties of this printer. From the box that opens, there is an advanced option which shows you the paper output, whether you want to collate it, the number of copies that you are wanting to make, the type of graphics that you want to use, image color management. Then there are options for document options, whether you want to enable the advanced print features, and also option for layout, what type of layout you want to give. You can define the page order. Then if you go into printing shortcuts, it gives you quick shortcuts for your print command. You can select the print quality, normal or first draft. So you can have various print qualities. You can also have different types of paper. So you can select the paper type. For instance, you want to print on plain paper. You have options for printer's paper size. So you can select that. Letter size, legal size. Then you can also select the orientation of your printer. Whether it is to be printed in portrait or landscape mode. You can also opt to print on both sides of the paper. So you can use these. Then if you go to the paper quality option, it has many options available to define the paper quality. For instance, you can select the size and you can have various options, A5, B5, the document size, whether it's executive or legal or letter size. You can scroll up and down and select the options that you want to choose. Click on OK. And in this, you also can define the type. Type in plain paper, and also the print quality, whether you want normal or you want to make any changes there, you can define that. When you go to the effects option, you can see whether you want to print in the actual size or you want to make some changes to the print task. So if you select print document on, you have an option available of various sizes. So you can choose the size that you're looking for. So there are many options, and you will get to know these options when you practice with these options. So the normal size, you can select percentage. If it's 100%, it's a normal size. You can see the changes being shown in the preview window here. If you're changing the size to 100%, 132%, so it shows you in the preview window. You can just use the scroll bar also for the size of the print paper printout or page printout. Then you can also apply a watermark on the page that you are printing on by choosing this option here. There are more options for finishing, what type of a finish you want in your print task. So you can define one page per sheet, two pages per sheet. You can change that. You can change the orientation, and you can even change the color, whether you want to print in grayscale or in high quality, or you want to use only the black print cartridge. If you want, you can also give a name for your print task, quick sets here. Click on OK. Click on OK on this box also. So this is how you can use the printer setup. There is an options button also. You can see various options available here for comments, for pages, for the contents, and so on. So you can select these options also for the printing. So there are many, many options available in the printer setup. You can choose from where the paper has to be taken, paper tray, or print automatically on the inserted pages. If you want, you can choose the fax option also from here. So there are various options available, and you can choose to print using any of these options. Click on OK to close this box. This is how you will be using the printer setup. Let us now learn about templates. Do you know what happens with templates? Using the option of templates, you can make templates which you can use later. You can paste a prepared template in your document. You may have seen that in mobiles, there are some ready-made messages available, like, I am in a meeting, I will call you back, etc. And you can send these messages without having to type them. Templates are used in a similar way. Watch this video to know more about how templates are used. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the templates on our writer page. Just like in a mobile, you have some predefined templates which have messages like, I am in a meeting and I will call you back. So without typing, you can directly send that message to people. Similarly, in this writer page, you can create templates, save them, and then paste them where you want it. Take your pointer to the file menu, and in this, look for the submenu for templates. In this, there is an option called save. Click on that. The first option here is new template. So you can type a name for your template and then click on OK. So your template has been saved. Once again, let's go to file menu. Come back to the templates option. And this time, from the options here, look for organize. Click on that and it shows you how you can manage your templates. Click on my templates. Look for the CS123, the template that we had just saved. Click on that and then click on the drop-down button for commands and click on export template. A box opens and you can click on save to save your template at the desired location, which is desktop. Let's close this, and now let's use the file menu. Let's minimize and see on the desktop where we have saved our template. Double click on that and you can see your template. So this is already existing in your template. Let us use the file menu, go to new, open a new text document, and we want to bring our template here. Once again, take the pointer to the file menu, go to new option, and here in the end you see templates and documents. Click there, you will see options here. So select the templates option, because you want to select your template. Go to my templates and click on the template that you had created, which is CS123. You can see all the details here on the right side. Click on open, and in your text document your predefined template will open up. So this is how you can use the template option on your writer page to create, save and use the template. Since we will now end today's class here, all of you close your file and properly shut down your computers. In today's class, you learned about some of the options of the standard toolbar, and you also learned about some of the options of the file menu, like send, properties, templates, printer settings. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.